Hello, Narnach here. Welcome back to the Division. After doing some of the side content in the previous two episodes, we're gonna run a mission again today. It's gonna be the Hudson refugee camp. So, let's roll the intro words.
Agent, we, meaning Dr. Candle, need you to secure the Hudson rail yards area. The yards have become a tent city for the destitute and desperate, the people forced out of every place else and up here. What we're looking for is blood samples from those refugees, clean ones, sick ones, and ones who might have survived the dollar flu for Dr. Candle to work her magic on. So if you secure the site, we can do the rest.
Okay. Find blood samples for the doctor. So, let's see. Follow the orange diamond.
Echo available for playback nearby.
Things are burning. Corpses are burning. And also, our buddies, the cleaners, are up ahead. Also, there's an echo here. Let's activate the echo. I like how they did the echoes.
Oh, that's nasty. God, I think I'm gonna be sick.
Hey, it's this or nothing.
So you see all the people here, and this is basically just a holographic recreation based on all the data that's available from the internet and surveillance cameras and things like that. And I think the concept is also nice. It's good. At some point, once we actually get holographic technology that works and you can use outdoors, I can actually imagine using this to recreate scenes outside as well. Pretty cool. Alright, let's go combat. We have our buddies here, the cleaners. Let's perform a sweep. Some to the left, some ahead. Let's we've got the problem that we have headshots that hit them for 99% of their life, so we actually need to hit them twice. Burn me out. There you are. Ooh, hit this tank. He's not gonna be happy. Let's reload so we can actually pump him full of lead. Hello there. Boom. Oh, there are more. Oh wait, you don't want to get too close to him. Oh, also, here, have a sniper rifle in the face. Ow. 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 He stood in the fight. Well, they do sneak up on you, that's a nasty bit. So he also dropped a med pack. Let's actually run by it to grab it. There's another one, that's good. So sweep. Is that all? No, see, there's still more guys. So you didn't hit him twice. That one we could actually hit in one go. Interesting that the melee is actually easier to kill. Purple guy. He dropped his grenade because I shot him. Always a good way for them to die. Whoa. Let's get out of there.
Agent, you need to hear this. Faye tells me the cleaners are holding the entire tent city prisoner. That's what it looks like, and it fits the cleaner MO. If you wanted to eradicate every last vestige of detectable virus, where would you go? wherever the biggest concentrations are. Refugee camps, shanty towns. Jesus, you don't think they'd...
Draconian solution, but highly effective.
Sure, if you're a genocidal maniac.
And
you ever wonder if we even deserve to survive this thing?
Every
day, Doctor. Every day. Good luck, Agent.
It's actually, I like the short voiceover sequences that just intersperse the missions like that. Give you something to listen to while you're looking for loot and other useful things. Would it be on the roof? It's just inside here. Medkits. Well, got all of them though. Unfortunately, let's keep going. Some bomb there. Proximity bombs. If you get too close, they explode. There's something blinking there as well. Shoot it. There as well. This is something the cleaners like to do. They like fire, that also and they also like explosives. As a result, you're gonna encounter a lot of them when fighting them. I will miss a couple. Yeah, see? Yeah. Spotted it in time. If you get hit by them, oh, you're gonna be set on fire, take damage. So it's gonna be all around unpleasant experience. Is there an exit? Could actually, no, you can't. You can't get out. You can shoot through, but you can't actually get out. You can get out here though. We're gonna go up here again.
Warning, contamination levels increasing.
You hear that, Agent? You're walking into the teeth of it now.
So...
don't forget what I said about keeping any infected refugees alive. I mean, obviously you're gonna try and keep them all alive, but I need those virus samples, and I really need viable antibody samples from survivors. So keep them extra alive, I guess. You know what I'm saying.
Keep people extra alive. Yes.
Candle out.
Pretty easy spot. And yeah, I mean, when you're on fire, you're in a sort of kind of helpless state. Not very pleasant. Find it easiest to just shoot all the traps so you're not gonna accidentally wander into them during a fight. Interestingly, those guys don't get triggered by the explosions. And he's a firecracker now. Usually there are more. Let's have a quick look. What's that? That's not an explosive. Just appeared that to be that way. So all the yellow things I'm now triggered by. Especially if you're running from cover to cover, it's easy to miss them. See, so you wanna go over there now. Boom. So, let's do a sweep. Oh, it actually highlights traps. I'm very pleased with that. I saw lots of fire there, might be boss. Not just a regular flamer guy. You show your head, please. Thank you. Also, the traps are on the right side, so if you stick a bit to the left side here, should be good. Also, there. Is this area here that we're not specifically sent to go to? Is there something lootable here? Ooh, it's a box. Adjustable knee pads. Apparently, this is an upgrade. Now I'm gonna sort through little loot later after the episode, so gonna keep this just focused on the gameplay. And of course on the loot, nothing here. Another backpack. And we got a soda. Oh well, we can give it to the civilian somewhere. Don't see any explosives in here. This one over there. If you're moving, you got a very large rectangle, and then if you stand still, it actually focuses. Ow! That was around the corner. Yeah. Okay, we have to be heading over here. Ooh, buddy. Neutralized him. Well, we can do that. Let's start out by neutralizing them extra hard with a grenade. And then we sweep, see who's left. No threats, just neutrals. Good. Just some refugees here.
Warning.
Lots of stuff to loot.
Chemical signature of explosives detected.
Confirmed. It's Napalm B, all right. With that much capacity, they must be planning to burn out the whole damn yard. And when they do, they're gonna kill every last refugee in that shanty town. We need that tank moved somewhere safe.
Hey. That's... there's just quite a bunch of backpacks here. Which seems to fit with the whole idea that this is where refugees are effectively stored, even though it's a bit degrading to say that about humans, but...
What do you think they're doing?
Honestly, I have no idea.
Let's have a look.
What do you think the pipes are for?
Restock. It's always good. Oh, nice. Let's see the setting civilians on fire. Let's not do that, mister. Ooh, sniper. Hey, fellow sniper. Oh, actually, he's a mechanic, not a sniper. He just looks like a sniper. Come on. Show you that. Yes. Next, you. I mean, I try to focus on getting my stamina decently high, so I can actually survive a couple of hits. Seems to work so far. Yeah, you're screwed, mister. Boom. Oh, more guys. Reload, very inopportune. Let's not have my cursor randomly jump about. Up the staircase. Find the chemical source. Up the ladder. There's a couple more packages here. One loot here, another loot here. Cool. Okay. There's also a restock on the other side of the wall. Of course it is. That's why we came in. My best buddy buddies. And I can just shoot them.
Remember
Let's see. Two regular guys. There as well. Let's see. Here's his backpack. And I do the same with those guys. That worked. Ah, almost worked actually. He's nearly dead. Yeah, sorry. Well, not quite, really. They are the enemy, and therefore they must die. That's really all there is to it. Is there an alternative way to get down? Nope. Now we just take the staircase like regular people would. No heroic entrance. Well, not at least without making it hurt. Did I just spot a ladder in here? I think I did. But it's on the inside. So it would be very nice if you could get up there as a sniper tower. Can you go up? Curious mind wants to know. No, you cannot get up there. So, unfortunately, that is not something you can do. Okay, let's reach the train controls then. Let's actually go for the mission. This guy running. Cool. Didn't realize you could actually shoot through their shields.
Okay, Agent. As soon as you lock the situation down, I've got a joint Sarah JTF strike force ready to move in. They'll take samples from as many refugees as they can find. Medical personnel?
Notice the recurring theme.
A couple of EMTs in the mix, Doctor? Yes.
A couple? As in only two?
Whenever I clear out an entire level, they send in an army of other guys. Basically, to just keep things safe afterwards.
Samples, I assume.
Or infecting themselves. Yes. I'll take your word for it. Thank you, Doctor. Get moving, Agent.
Oh, that's a turret, not a guy. Let's do a sweep. Have a look where people are. That's the technician dropping.
This is Dr. Candle. Sampling team, can you hear me?
What's out here? Go ahead, Doctor.
Oh, Lieutenant. Good. Listen. I need you guys to log intake info from everybody you get a sample from. Age, gender, ethnicity, general state of health on a 10-point scale. Then label and group the samples according to...
He threw a grenade.
Excuse me, Doctor. But maybe this could wait until we get confirmation the op is actually complete. You saying you don't have faith in your agent? Just focusing on the task at hand. Lieutenant, you'll radio the doctor as soon as the area is secured.
Yes, ma'am. Don't worry, Doctor. Okay. We'll get it all worked out.
I hope so.
I was just thinking I probably need
species we're talking about.
Some ammo regen. And
copy
here we
that,
are.
Doc.
There is some ammo. Where's the ammo? Ah, there. Okay. 87 marksmen. So quick run around. Is there any additional loot? Nope. No. So actually there is. Didn't see it. Didn't jump out. Ah, there. It's just a backpack, it just blends into the background. But you got another med pack. I approve of med packs. And we have a box here with a classic carbine. That's a form of sniper rifle, if I understood correctly. And then we go up the ladder over there.
You know the situation, it's too late for these people here.
Actually, gonna
dead,
go upstairs, come better flank them.
But it's not too late for us. If we do what we gotta do, it might not be too late for the rest of the country. So go to work.
Then approach it from this angle as anyway, just to have a pretty good view. Let's actually do a sweep as well, see where they are. Okay, that's plan almost worked. Yeah. Bye bye. We got that guy, of course. He's probably gonna get up the stairs. I was expecting there to be more enemies. Because often that is the case. Yeah, there's a grenadier. Yeah, fire in the hole. And then you shoot them, they drop the grenade, and it gets a lot more fun. Guys over there, so yellow actually. Oh. Ah. Kind of got hit by a flamer guy there. Wasn't quite the plan. Let's do some healing.
Everybody goes, all in.
He hurt. Okay, so there's a turret in the back. Yeah.
Yeah, burn, don't it?
The boss guy next to it, so he is a mechanic or turret operator or however you would want to call him. Had one bullet in the gun, and I knew I needed to kill him with headshots, so I went for the flamer tank instead. That actually works in one shot. He's far enough away that I can actually hit him. Cool. And the turret, the range on the turret is too short, so you can't actually hit me. Cool. I think the enemy AI was a bit, but was not optimal there. He should have done something rather than stay where he was when he got shot at. I can't cross this, then we need to walk around. Did drop a couple of items. 3 greens and a light blue cosmetic item. Yeah, was also what she wrote. Let's see, we go... Oh, use the keypad.
Agent, if you can find the crane controls, drop that tank someplace safe.
Drop it someplace safe? Let's see, we use the laptop, because laptops control everything these days. Ooh, look, it's a tank. Dropped. Boom.
That should do it, Agent.
That. Solid work.
Yeah, good work.
Refugee
now,
camp.
Sample team, listen up. Like I was saying, I'm gonna need those blood samples labeled and organized so we can track corroborating factors. Let's move this discussion to a different channel so we don't bore the agent.
That's a very good thing. So then we exit. Rather. Oh wait, actually. Rather graceful. I see rope thingies here. Yes, that's the technical term. They're called rope thingies. Release the rope thingies. And someone dropped a cell phone. It seems like. Which is free experience.
I mean, forced relocations, this dark zone. What is the point of that?
We've already had a press conference on this.
Hey, the comparative data you secured from the train yard. I mean, those refugees, of course. It gave us something to think about. There's another report in the database for you to look at.
Okay. So, We're now in the middle of the mission area that we just started. And something I discovered, there's a mission overview here where you can actually see all the different story missions and encounters in the game. And different events and tutorial things. It's actually pretty nice. So this is also a nice way to see what have I done and what haven't I done yet. So up here we have a level 14 mission that's going to be a bit too difficult. There's a level 8 here. Then there's a level 10 here. Level 6. Wait, we didn't do this already? Oh wow, then we definitely need to do it. Subway Mark is the mission from the... Whatchamacallit? From the beta. This unlocks the tech wing for us. Hey, I think that's gonna be the next step then. Let's actually travel back to base and have a quick look what we have. Also, we got 800 points so in the medical wing. So let's see if we can spend them on something useful. Maybe to unlock some new skills or some new skill specializations. Maybe we need a couple more points because there's also some things that cost 1,000 points. Also, I need to confirm the fast travel. That might be useful. I think if you select another player and you do the fast travel, it just instantly goes. But to your base of operations, you need to actually double confirm it by pressing the space bar. At least that's how I think it works. Feels a bit inconsistent. Also, it's very snowy and foggy right now. So, base restoration. Yeah, see? We still need to activate the tech wing. So that's what we're going to do next. Next mission, we activate the subway morgue. If you played the beta, you have seen the mission already. But it's gonna be part of all the content. So we do it anyway. It's gonna be good. Let's see, survival guys. They actually show you how many you've got. Cool. So medical wing upgrades. Let's see what we get and what we can get. That's more important. So a virus lab. It gives us the support station. And a perk that gives us one extra virus protection, protecting us when we go into contaminated areas, which is pretty cool. I think, what was it, pharmacy? Pharmacy gives the same perk actually, also plus one virus protection level. And this show gives you some talents, this only gives you a skill. Disaster aid gives you a recovery link. Heals and cures the user and nearby allies, so this is more of a group skill rather than a solo player skill. Let's see, we got quarantine. It adds a couple of mods to the pulse, which is useful because we use it. Intensive care. That seems to boost the heal. And we get an extra medkit. That's maybe not a bad idea to grab that for the... for now. Let's see, this helps you ally revive allies, which is not quite useful again in PvE content if you're playing solo, but even in a group it's gonna be very useful because you can throw your heal. So if you can throw the defibrillator to remotely revive allies, then you can actually help revive them when they are in a compromised position without exposing yourself to attack. That's gonna be very good. Very good indeed. Let's see, heals the target more efficiently and may even extend the target's health beyond its normal rating. First aid mods, that's gonna be good, the overdose. First aid mods will give you a damage boost, which is also nice. Let's take intensive care with the first aid bonus.
Looks perfect. I can't thank you enough. But I will bring you something from my wine rack.
New abilities are ready to set up. So, quarantine is gonna boost the pulse, which is also something we use. So, let's boost both of them. So, let's have a quick look at our abilities. So, four. The pulse, we just have our basic pulse. We can turn it into a recon pack, which increases the range and it locates nearby loot containers. That's very good because I like loot and I like extended range because I'm a sniper, so it's good to see enemies from afar. You've got the Scrambler that protects you from hostile pulses, which is good for PvP but not so much for PvE. And you got a tactical scanner. Damage is increased when attacking any hostile targets identified by the pulse scan. So that's just damage boost on top of everything. So let's go with the recon pack. You see the icon change because I selected it. So next up, first aid. Basic first aid is just 450 HP. 3 meter range, deploys cooldown 42 seconds. The defibrillator can revive the downed allies. Well, that's not useful. Overdose is very useful. The heal is up from 450 to 619, so that's about a third extra. Range is a bit shorter, but for self use, it's just good. And the deploy range is actually larger. That's also pretty cool. So you could throw it further in case you're helping allies. And the cooldown is still the same, 42.5 seconds. And the booster shot actually heals less on yourself, more on allies. And the range is the same. So let's go for overdose. We have a very strong heal now, which is good. And with that, I'm gonna thank you very much for watching and hope to see you again next time. Bye bye.